Shalom, all praise and honor glory to Yahweh, Bashim Yahushua, double honors to the elder apostles, the great millstone. Salutations to Yaakim, teaching all truth and sincerity. And risk your lives to do so. This is a lesson on cutting the hell doctrine. Just cutting the hell doctrine, plainly. So I'm going to start in Ecclesiastes 12 and 7. Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall return unto the Most High Yahweh who gave it. So, when you die, your body is basically returns back to the earth, because basically, I believe in Ecclesiastes when I'm going to read it, it's the third chapter. It says, thus you are, thus you shall return. I'm going to read it right quick. Hold on. So, Ecclesiastes 3 and verse 20. So this is Ecclesiastes verse 20. All go unto one place, all are of the dust, and all turn to dust again. So, just like in Job said, when worms destroy this body, but in my flesh I shall see, the Most High, basically. So Job knew of reincarnation. He knew that he would come back in the in a new body and new flesh, but it'd be the same spirit. So you go back to the Most High Yahweh. Your spirit goes back to him, you return to him, and basically you don't, like, on the other side there's no hell, you know. So these vessels we are in basically are just vessels, you know. Like, this is a temple, basically. So your spirit, this spirit inside this temple can move on to a new temple and lodge in that temple as long as, for how long the Most High wants you to lodge in the temple. You could lodge in the temple for 100 years. You know, it depends on how long the Most High wants you to lodge in this temple until he ends up taking you out of this temple by you dying, you know. And once you die, you return to him in the spirit world, where you're at rest in paradise, basically. Because the spirit world is not a place where you go and there's hell and you have to sit in a fire pit for all eternity. You know, in the spirit world you go and you're at rest, you know. You're basically at rest, you know. So I'm going to read Ecclesiastes 3 and 16. This is Ecclesiastes 3 and 16. And moreover, I saw under the sun a place of judgment, that wickedness was there, and a place of righteousness, that iniquity was there. So basically, judgment is played out on the earth. So in this right here, it says, moreover, I saw under the sun a place of judgment, and wickedness was there. So the earth is under the sun, so judgment is played out on the earth. So that scripture just said, basically, judgment is here, down here on earth. So this place is hell, basically. This place is, you know, hell on earth. This is basically, we're living hell on earth, basically. So I'm going to go to Deuteronomy 32. And I'm going to start at 21. So, I don't know why I did that. 32:20. This is Deuteronomy 32 and 21. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not, God. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities. I will move them to jealousy, which with those which are not a people. I provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. For a fire is kindled in my anger, and shall burn unto lowest hell, and shall consume the earth with her increase, and set on fire the foundations of the mountain. I will heap mischief upon them. I will spin my arrow around them. They shall be burnt with hunger and devoured with burning heat, with bitter destruction. I will also send the teeth of beasts upon them, and the poisonous serpents of the dust. The sword without and terror within shall destroy both the young men and the virgin, the suckling also with the man of gray hair. I said, I will scatter them into corners. I would make the remembrance of them to cease from among men. Were it not that I feared the wrath of the enemy, lest their adversaries should behave themselves strangely, and lest they should say, our hand is high, and Yahweh have not done all this. So, burning heat, destruction, slavery, heathens ruling over us, basically, this place is hell, you know, and, you know, so I'm going to go to Psalms 86:13. For great is thy mercy towards me, thou hast delivered my soul from the lowest hell. Delivering us from this slavery, destruction, burning heat, heathens ruling over us, you know. We are in hell, living in torment and captivity. So we are in hell, definitely living in torment and captivity, because we got to get up and work every day. Basically, most brothers have to work every day. Most brothers work 7 days a week. That's basically hell. That's basically captivity. You got to go to work every day a week. You got to deal with Esau at work, and because he's basically the boss over you, or you got a nigga woman as a boss, but you got to deal with Esau, the nigga woman. You got to deal with nigga woman ain't right. The your children ain't right. That's hell. Your family ain't right. That's hell. Dealing with all this stuff in the world, all the stuff around you is basically going through hell, you know, and dealing with, you know, and also dealing with seeing your people not in their right mind. That's also a part of being in hell, because you know, you know about this knowledge, you know about the truth, you know that you're an Israelite, but like some brothers, like me, when I see my mom and them go to that church, I be wondering like, when will they ever wake up, or will they just wait until the kingdom to wake up? Or like my dad, he still loved that church, you know. He still loved going to that church, but he's been there since he was my age, because I'm about to turn 23, and he's been there for a long time. But he's been there since he was like 20, like almost 30 years at least. So the thing is, like, dealing with going to work and dealing with, you know, these, you know, two-third Jakes is kind of hell in a sense, because like you dealing with all these things. If you got a family of your own, or you dealing with your family that, because you ain't got no woman or children, but you dealing with your moms and them, that's kind of hell on you. So it's like, and dealing with Esau is hell, especially if he is dealing with you unrighteously, or he's, you know, basically on you. So that's hell, basically. And we also in captivity, so that's hell. So I'm gonna read Revelations 21 and verse 1. And I'm gonna end it on that. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. This is Revelation 21 verse 1. I saw a new heaven and new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth was passed away, and there was no more sea. I'm gonna read a little bit more. And I John saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from the Most High out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. So this heaven, the new heaven and new earth, is gonna be like the first heaven and the first earth will pass away. So we'll be ruling in the kingdom. So that's basically our rulership that's going to bring about a new heaven and a new earth. Because once the so-called Negroes, Latino, Native Americans, men of the 144 are beamed up in chariots and are given those new bodies and are given crowns and basically enact rulers and governors and judges all throughout the entire kingdom, are sitting on the thrones, who are putting the nations into basically subjection and putting them in slave chains and on them ships that are going to be taken over to our land, and they're going to build up our walls and build up our streets, and they're going to build our palaces, and they're going to make our palaces look amazing, because if they don't, they're going to get their ass whooped. But anyway, well, we're going to beat them so they can make our shit right, you know? Like, Jake know what we want in our palaces, you know, especially the elect. They going to want some nice, they're going to want the finest chairs. Like, we're going to have nice tables, you know? So once we get that rulership, because I remember and I do believe when Solomon, King Solomon ruled for 40 years of peace. So when King Solomon got the throne and was ruling for 40 years, there was no wars, because King David put his foot up all them other nations' asses. He put his foot straight up every nation's ass. So there was 40 years of peace. So as soon as, like, while King Solomon was ruling, there was 40 years of peace. And I'm reading scripture. Hold on. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. When the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. So basically, when the righteous rule, people rejoice. So the entire earth will be rejoicing once the nation of Israel is back on top and the other nations are back in slavery. Every nation, once Esau is down, once Esau is completely down and completely back in chains, Because we had Esau under subjection during the time of King Solomon. We had Esau under subjection, under rulership, under control. Well, we basically chased him to the Caucasus Mountains during the time of the Byzantine Empire, because they were kicked out of Europe, kicked out of those lands, because the people who actually ruled Europe for a long time were so-called the Southern Kingdom of Israel, part of the Southern Kingdom of Israel. So, So when Esau is out of rulership and the other nations are part of being slaves with him, we will definitely have better peace. Peace will be on actually and be on earth once the Israelites are in rulership. So I believe I covered everything. I'm going to say all praise and glory to Yahweh and Yahshai. And there is no such thing as hell in the spirit world. Hell is on earth. And your spirit goes to the spirit world and returns back to the Most High Yahweh. And you're actually at rest. And you don't deal with the cares of this life anymore. You know? I believe in the scriptures it says the ones that are dead, they know of nothing. Like they're really not concentrating on what happens down here because they're up there in peace and rest, you know. Like our people up there are not really concentrating on what goes down here, really, you know, unless they're in the flesh, unless they come back in the flesh. That's when their mind is down here. But when they're in the spirit world, their mind is up what is going on in the spirit world, what's happening up there, you know? So I'm going to end it with that. I'm going to say all praise and glory to Yahweh Shem Yahshai, double honesty of apostles, the great millstone, and salutations to Akim teaching all truth and sincerity. I'm going to say shalom, and, you know.